Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about the various types of bonds that are found in polymers. The types of bonds that hold polymers together provide lots of knowledge into how the polymer will react under different characterization methods, such as how the polymer will react to being heated up, its elasticity, and many other things. In general, we can differentiate the types of bonds that hold polymers together as primary or secondary bonds. Let's first focus on the stronger of the two, and that is primary bonds. Primary bonds are covalent bonds. These are likely to be the strongest types of bonds that you will encounter in polymer engineering. Although, in general, ionic bonds are stronger than covalent bonds, these types of bonds are very uncommon in polymer engineering. So, you've probably heard of this type of bond before in any intro to chemistry class. These are the bonds that occur when two neighboring atoms share a set of electrons, causing a chemical connection between the two atoms. In polymer engineering, these types of bonds can act as links or connectors between our various monomers and polymers. The benefits to covalent bonds are that they are very strong, which gives the polymer excellent chemical and thermal stability, which, depending on your desired application, is usually very desirable. Chemical stability means that our polymer is less reactive and will often remain inert. Thermal stability means that if our polymer is heated, the bonds that connect our monomers will remain attached longer. These types of bonds can be found in both thermoplastics and thermosets. However, if the covalent bonds connect the polymers to one another, we will get a thermoset, because when the heat is applied, this cross-linking of the polymers will prevent the polymers from moving around and reorienting themselves, which is the reason that thermoplastics are able to be reshaped when heated. So, now that we have covered primary bonds, what are the secondary bonds in polymer engineering? Well, there are two secondary bonds of interest in polymer engineering. Firstly, let's talk about van der Waals forces and then go into hydrogen bonding. Van der Waals forces are weak forces that are caused by slight differences in the electrical charge of individual molecules and atoms at a given time. These types of forces are often described as London dispersion forces, or dipole-dipole forces, which we will talk about shortly in the hydrogen bonding section. So, because of this, let's focus on London dispersion forces, which are temporary forces between molecules that arise from slight, non-permanent differences in the electrical charge. The way I like to think of this is imagining the electrons around an atom being random, and this randomness can cause local, short-distance attractions between molecules. The weak force keeping the two regions together is called a van der Waals force. These bonds are common in thermoplastic materials, as when energy is applied to the polymer through heating it, these weak forces can easily be broken and then the polymer can slide around and reorient themselves more easily. Whereas in thermosets, they are not present or very weak and therefore not dominant. Lastly, let's talk about hydrogen bonding in polymers. Hydrogen bonds are quite a bit stronger than van der Waals forces. However, they are still relatively weak when compared to covalent bonds. Just as a brief example, let's look at these two water molecules. The hydrogen region will be slightly positive, as the attached oxygen atom will hog the shared electrons. This is because it has a higher electronegativity. The same thing will occur on the right water molecule, and therefore the oxygen atom will retain a slight negative charge. Therefore, we have a region of slight positive charge and a region of slight negative charge. And intuitively, we know that these two regions will want to be together, so they do. As we previously talked about, hydrogen bonds also begin with a dipole being created from the different electronegativities of the bonded atoms which we just showed previously. Therefore, these differences in electronegativities lead to much more permanent dipoles than that experienced in the previously talked about van der Waals forces. So, hydrogen bonded to oxygen, fluorine, and nitrogen are common examples where a dipole is created. So, hydrogen bonding is caused by this dipole-dipole interaction. In summary, we covered van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonding, and covalent bonding. To reiterate, covalent bonding is the strongest type of bond we will likely experience in polymer engineering. Then we have hydrogen bonding, and then van der Waals forces are the weakest of the three. Spending time understanding your polymer and how its monomers attach to one another and how the various polymers interact with one another can greatly aid your understanding of a polymer sample's properties as a whole. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the various types of bonds that are prevalent in polymer engineering. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.